deeper in love with you, deeper in love with you.
I love you more than anything I love.
Deeper in love with you, deeper in love with you.
Oh, how I love you, Lord.
很高兴又可以回到大家这里。I
think last time I spoke was maybe 2 years ago.
上一次我来的时候好像是两年前。
And it's always a joy.
每一次来到这里都很喜乐。
Because I grew up in New York City, I always tell people that, and I think I've mentioned that to you.
我想我跟大家说过，我是在纽约长大的。
And I was raised on a, I became a Christian when I was 7 years old in a church in Chinatown in New York City.
我是七岁的时候在纽约中国城的教会里得救。
And it was a bilingual church, Cantonese and English.
当时也是一个双语的教会，是广东话跟英文。
And we met in a little upstairs in an apartment floor, a flat in the second floor.
那我们聚会的地方是在一个那个公寓的二层楼。
And if you ever visit New York City, Chinatown, restaurants are on the bottom.
如果你去过纽约的中国城，你就知道第一层呢都是餐馆。So
there was the restaurant, the church, and then people living on top of us in the apartment building.
所以第一楼是餐馆，第二楼是教会，然后上面是住家。And
it's been a long journey since I was raised in New York City.
自从我在纽约长大到现在，这是一条很漫长的路。The
last time I spoke, I was Associate Professor of Theology at Western Seminary.
上次我来的时候呢，我是在 Western 的这个 神学院当教授。
But now I am a pastor with Peninsula Bible Church in Palo Alto.
但是现在呢，我在 Palo Alto 的这个 圣经 教会 Bible Peninsula 半岛圣经教会，我在那边牧会。
And so I have a very unique role there.
所以我在那里呢，我有一个很特殊的角色。Because
I'm there to develop their training institute.
因为我在那里呢，我要建造他们的 训练中心。And
because of that, the church has given me a luxury that a lot of other pastors don't have.
因为这个特殊的角色的缘故呢，教会给我很多的自由度，是其他牧师没有的。Which
is they give me the freedom to speak at other churches as we minister to the whole Bay Area.
所以呢，他们就让我很自由的可以在湾区各个教会讲道。You
say, well, what are other churches like in the Bay Area? You may ask, what are other churches like?
你可能会问我，那其他在湾区的教会是什么样的情形呢？
Well, just on Thursday, I was at a church called Bridges in Los Gatos.
就像礼拜四我在Los Gatos 的一个教会叫 Bridges.
Oh, big church.
它是一个很大的教会。
Los Gatos is very, very expensive to live.
你知道 Los Gatos 是一个很贵的区域。
Oh, no, no, not Los Gatos, Los Altos.
Los Altos.
That's even better, more expensive, or just as expensive.
Los Altos.
Bridges is in Los Altos, yeah.
是 Bridges 在 Los Altos, 那是一个更贵的区域。
So I was addressing about 65 pastors in the Bay Area and in the Fresno and Sacramento area. Thursday.
Thursday. You were not in Bridges?
Oh, I was at Bridges speaking to 65 pastors.
礼拜四呢，我就是在 Bridges， 我跟65位的牧会的牧师们在那边讲道。
Oh, what a nice church.
那真是一个很好的教会，很大的教会。
My own church, Peninsula Bible Church, is in Palo Alto.
那我自己的现在牧会的地方是在 Palo Alto.
And there is also a very expensive place to live.
那当然，那也是一个很贵的区域。
And the building is not as nice as Los Altos.
但是我们的建筑，教会的建筑不像 Los Altos 那个教会那么好。
But it is very nice.
但是也是非常的好。
3 weeks from now, I'll be speaking in San Jose in a church in Lincoln Glen.
那三个礼拜之后呢，我会在San Jose 的一个教会。
And it is a smaller church.
那是一个比较小的教会。
And what I've noticed is that all churches have their differences in how the building is laid out.
所以我就发现每一个教会呢，他们的建筑可能都不太一样。
How the services are run.
然后他们的信他们的敬拜的信这些也不太一样。
How the band and worship team sings.
他们的敬拜团队他们怎么样服侍也不太一样。
How the congregation and the leadership dress.
还有弟兄姐妹还有教会的领袖们他们的穿着也不太一样。
They're all different.
每一个都不一样。
Because what unifies us in Christ is not the form or the building or that we all sing the same songs or we all dress the same way. That is not what unifies us in Christ.
因为在基督里我们之所以能够合一不是因为我们穿着一样或是我们敬拜的方式一样或是我们的教会建筑一样。
For when we understand worship and understand what is at the center of worship, there is something much more important than the form of worship.That brings us together on Sunday mornings.
如果我们要知道敬拜的真意的话，我们就要知道为什么敬拜这个是超过了敬拜外面的形式。
You see, in America, many people worship Christ on Sunday morning, but the question I have, do they really understand what worship is?
在美国，每一个主日早上都有许多的人在敬拜神，但是我想问一个问题。他们真的了解什么是敬拜吗？
Because there's a difference between going to a worship service and truly worshiping Christ in your heart.
因为去教会参加一个敬拜的仪式，跟心里真正的敬拜神是很不一样的。
And we can be easily fooled into say, oh, we came here in this beautiful building at and we worship God.
我们很容易就误会就把自己想成我在敬拜神。如果我们每个礼拜主日早上来一个很美好的教堂来敬拜，参加敬拜的仪式。
I've been in the pastoral ministry for 26 years now.
我牧会已经牧会了26年。
And I've come to observe that many many people go to church without really understanding who Jesus is.
所以我已经发现，而且观察到许多的人，他们来到教会里，但是他们并不认识耶稣是谁。
And with that introduction, we come to the text today.
接下来呢，我们就要看今天所要讲的经文。
It is found in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 21, and I will be teaching from verses 12 to 16.
今天我们要讲的经文呢，是在马太福音21章12到16节。
Oh, there it's up on the screen. Let me read it. And Jesus went into the temple of God and cast out all them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves. And he said unto them, It is written, My house shall be called the house of prayer.But ye have made it a den of thieves. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. And when the chief priests and scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying in the temple and saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were sore, and said unto him, Hearest thou what these say? And Jesus saith unto them, Yea, have you never read, Out of the mouth of babes and sucklings thou hast perfected praise. I'll read verse 17. And he left them and went out of the city into Bethany, and he lodged there. Would you like to read?
Sure. 我们来读中文的12-16节。耶稣进了圣殿，赶出圣殿里所有在做买卖的人，推倒兑换银钱之人的桌子和卖鸽子之人的凳子，对他们说，经上记着，我的殿要称为祷告的殿，你们倒使它成为贼窝了。在圣殿里有盲人和瘸子到耶稣跟前，他就治好了他们。祭司长和文士看见耶稣所行的奇事，又见小孩子在圣殿里喊着说，何塞那归于大卫之子，就很生气，对他说，这些人所喊的你听到了吗？耶稣对他们说，听到了，经上说，你借孩童和吃奶的口发出完全的赞美，你们没有念过吗？
Now this is a very famous passage in the Bible.
这段圣经在圣经里面非常有
名。It is the one where Jesus, what we call, cleanses the temple and throws out money changers in the temple.
因为在这里呢，耶稣进了圣殿，洁净圣殿，并且推倒兑换银钱之人的桌子。
But to understand this passage better, you need to understand that actually there were two things happening in the temple.
我们要更多了解这段经文呢，我们必须知道在这里发生了两件事。
In verses 12 and 13, there is the cleansing of the temple, but then in verse 14 to 16, there is the healing of the sick and the praise that results from the healing of the sick.
所以十二到十三节呢，在这里耶稣洁净圣殿，推倒了兑换银钱之人的桌子。但是十四到十六节，我们看到在这里有医治发生，而且有赞美发生。
And also important in understanding this text is the context in which these episodes occur.
而且我们也为了要了解这段经文，我们也必须知道它的背景。
For Jesus in verse chapter 21 enters Jerusalem in what is known as the triumphal entry because in a few days Jesus will be betrayed and crucified.
因为在马太福音21章那里，我们知道耶稣呢，他凯旋进京，他进入耶路撒冷，而且再过几天他就要被钉死在十字架上。
The betrayal, the crucifixion, the resurrection, and the ascension would be the most important center event in the life of Jesus.
所以呢，被卖、被钉十字架，而且被埋葬，而且复活，这些是耶稣生命里面最重要的事情。
Without it, there would be no forgiveness of sins.
因为没有这些事情的话，罪就不得赦免。
Without it, without the resurrection, there would be no hope of a future.
如果没有复活的话，我们的未来就没有盼望。
Without the ascension, there will be no understanding of the power of God for us in Christ.
如果耶稣没有升天，我们就没有办法了解神伟大的能力在对我们在耶稣基督里。
But before he does that,
但是在他做这些事情之前，
he has to make a stop at one place.
他必须在一个地方停留一下。
The temple.
就是圣殿。
And that's a very, very interesting question. Have you ever been very busy? You had to go someplace.
这是一个很有意思的事情。你曾经有过你非常的忙碌，但是你必须要到一个地方吗？
Oftentimes you would be so focused that you just do the thing that you would go to the place that you're supposed to go. But Jesus needs to make this stop because unless he makes this stop, you will not really understand what Jesus is trying to do.
他有许多的事，很重要的事情他必须做，但是在他做之前，他必须在这里停留一下，不然我们没有办法真正的明白。
So what is it that Jesus does at this stop at the temple?
所以耶稣为什么要停留在圣殿里？
I'm going to read, but I'll read from my translation, which is the ESV. In verse 12, it goes like this, And Jesus entered the temple and drove out all who sold and bought in the temple, and he overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold pigeons. That's all I'll read. You can read.
Oh, okay. 12节，耶稣进了圣殿，赶出圣殿里所有在做买卖的人，推倒兑换银钱之人的桌子和卖鸽子之人的凳子。
Okay, what is Jesus doing? This is one of the few passages where Jesus is very, very upset.
那这里耶稣到底在做什么呢？在圣经里面，我们很少看见像这样子，耶稣非常的生气。
Oftentimes you see like paintings of Jesus, and Jesus is very calm, and he has a lamb usually, and he's like stroking the lamb. Very nice, very nice picture.
通常我们在油画里。我们在艺术画像里面看到的耶稣都是非常的温和，非常的宁静，而且他常常呢身边就带了一只羊在那边摸的那个小羊。
Very calm Jesus. We all like the calm Jesus.
我们都喜欢那个很平静、很宁静的那个耶稣。
Other pictures, and I used to work in a Christian bookstore in New York City. You would see maybe a picture, a painting of Jesus with the crown of thorns, and the suffering Jesus.
另外一个耶稣的形象呢，我以前在纽约呢，我曾经在一个基督教的书局里做事。那个我常常看见的另外一个画像，就是耶稣他头戴着荆棘的冠冕，就是一个受苦的耶稣。
Well, you see, but you never saw a picture of this in a painting.
但是我们很少看见在画像里面看见生气的耶稣。
Here, let me show you what the picture would look like.
让我表演给你们看这个。耶稣当时的情形就是这样子的。
Jesus is really upset.
耶稣非常的生气。
This is probably the most upset Jesus is.
这里大概就是耶稣最生气的时候。
Never even see the side of Jesus.
我们从来没有看到这一面的耶稣。
The question is, why is he so upset?
那问题就是为什么耶稣这么生气？
For he not only scolds them, but he overturns their tables.
不但骂他们，而且甚至把他们的桌子都推翻了。
You know, I'm Chinese.
我是一个中国人。
If I ever did that, I would like be looked upon as so rude that I would never be invited to a place again.
我是一个中国人，如果我这样子做的话，人家会觉得我这么的粗鲁，没有人会再请我去讲道。
Because we're Chinese people, even if we do not like it, we stay calm.
因为我们中国人，就算我们心里不高兴，我们表面还是非常的平和。
But Jesus kicks tables.
但是耶稣他会踢桌子。
Because this is why.
为什么呢？
The whole aspect of the text says that he was throwing the tables and the seats of those who were selling pigeons.
因为在这里，耶稣他所推倒的呢，是兑换银钱之人的桌子和卖鸽子之人的凳子。
Now the question is, what are they doing with selling animals?
那问题就是，为什么这些人要在圣殿里卖这些动物呢？
Maybe this church should sell animals in the hallway.
是不是我们教会也应该在走廊上卖一些这些动物呢？
Well, here it is.
这是为什么？
In the law of Moses, mostly found in the book of Leviticus,
在摩西的律法里面，特别是在利未记，
God, in commanding Moses what sacrifices would look like, always made a provision for poor people who could not afford the standard sacrifice.
当神在神所向摩西颁布的律法里面，他有讲说各样的献祭应该用什么样动物，但是他总是会说，对于穷人没有办法付得起的，他总是给他们有另外一个方式。
So in Leviticus, there was a lower standard of a sacrifice for women.Who could not afford the true animals, the good animals, and they could buy doves, because the whole thing wasn't that you know you had to pay for the top line of sacrifices. It was that you could come to God whether you were wealthy, whether you were middle class, or whether you were poor.
在这里呢，神颁布律法的时候呢，我在这里呢，就是说为这些女人，她们生产之后，她们想要来献祭。如果他们没有办法付得起这个一般的那个高标准的祭物的，他们可以买鸽子。所以呢，不管是穷人还是富人，或是中产阶级的人，他们都可以来敬拜神。
And God made the same provisions for those who have been purified by leprosy.
那同样的，当那些大麻风被洁净的人，神也一样的给他们这个例子。
For everyone is able to access God.
所以每一个人都可以到神的面前来。
So why is he kicking over these tables?
那为什么耶稣要在这里踢他们的桌子呢？
Because the emphasis was on the selling of these animals.
因为他们是在卖这些动物。
What's so interesting? If you read rabbinical literature that described what the temple worship was, it's very, very enlightening.
如果我们看我们看旧约里面到底这个在圣殿里面的敬拜是什么样子的呢？我们会得到很大的启示。
It had been said that in order to provide the best pigeons and the best doves that are, I guess, acceptable to God in sacrifice, that the purchaser would pay four times what the average price of a little bird was.
所以在这里呢，历史上告诉我们，当时他们在圣殿里面，如果他们要买一只鸽子，是完美无瑕疵的，是神可以悦纳的，是合乎律法要求的，他们必须要付四倍的价钱。
Oh, four times. That's a lot. That's a lot of money.
四倍的价钱，这是很多钱。
You ever go to the airport and want something to eat?
就像我们到机场想要买食物吃。
This bottle of water at Costco costs 50 cents.
如果我们买这瓶水在 Costco 差不多只要50 cents、
But at the airport, it's not 50 cents.
但是到飞机场呢，就不是五毛钱了。
Now, did you ever go to a movie theater and watch a movie?
你有没有去过电影院看电影？
This bottle of water in a movie theater would be $4, I think.
在电影院呢，这一瓶水差不多要四块美金。
Have you ever had popcorn in the movie theater?
你有没有在电影院买过爆米花
？Trader Joe, $1.99 for a big bag.
如果到 Trader Joe 的话，大概两块钱可以买一大包。
In a movie theater, $8-$9.
到电影院呢，差不多八九块美金。
But you say, well, these are, you know, this is the airport, this is a movie theater.
那你可能说这是在机场，这是在电影院呢
？Yeah, but this is the worship place of God.
但是圣殿是敬拜神的地方。
Fourfold.
四倍的价钱。
Not only was there a great profit in the selling of animals to the poor, the people who could afford it least, there was also profit in terms of the temple tax that had to be paid.
所以在那里呢，不单是卖鸽子可以赚钱，虽然说他们卖的是给最穷的人、最不能够付得起钱的人，而且另外呢，就是圣殿的税，他们也有这个兑换率。
For the text says Jesus overthrows the tables of those who are selling the birds, but he is also overthrowing the tables of those money changers.
所以圣经里告诉我们，耶稣不但推倒了这个卖鸽子之人的凳子。而且推倒了兑换银钱的人这个桌子。
So what are these money changers?
这些兑换银钱的人在做什么？
I'm going to Europe next year.
明年呢，我会到欧洲去。
No, not next year. In 3 months.
其实不是明年，今年三个月以后。
To see my nephew get married.
因为我的侄儿他要结婚。
And we will have to exchange some U.S. dollars for either pounds or euros.
所以我们到欧洲呢，我们就必须要兑换一下，不是欧元呢，就是英镑。
And you expect to pay them a few percentage for the exchange rate.
但是呢，在我们兑换的时候，我们总是要付一些的这些兑换钱的这些费用。
Okay, what's the exchange rate in the temple?
那么这个费用呢，在圣殿里的费用是多少呢？
It was described as 20% transaction.
在当时呢，是20%的这个手续费。
Wow. How much is your bank account making in interest?
现在你们银行里的利率是多少？
I would say if you are making 2% a year, you are doing pretty good.
如果你银行的利率一年可以有2%的利息已经不错了。
If I said to you, you could make 20% a day, 20% a day.
而且2%是年利息。如果我今天告诉你，你可以有每一天可以赚20%，
20% a day, that person's illegal. He's probably a gangster.
如果有一个人告诉你，你他可以让你一天赚20%，他可能是做违法的，搞不好他是帮派的。
No one charges 20% a day.
因为没有人会要20%的利息每一天。
This is what they were doing.
但是这就是这些兑换银钱的人在做的事。
And Jesus had to show his anger here.
所以耶稣在这里必须要表达出他的愤怒。
Because in the whole theology of the New Testament, even though God the Father does not dwell in a building, it represented his dwelling place.
虽然在新约里面，父神不是只单单住在圣殿里面，但是圣殿代表着神的同在。
And Jesus, as the Son of God, is defending the honor and the purpose of his Father's temple.
在这里呢，耶稣他神的儿子，他在这里要告诉人，圣殿是神父神的。
Because Jesus was not just any ordinary person.
因为耶稣不是只是任何一个普通人。
He was not simply a prophet.
他也不是只是单单是一位先知。
He is the very Son of God, upholding the purpose and honor of his Father.
他是神的儿子，在这里要彰显出来神的目标、神的目的和神的荣耀。
We do not do this. My Father does not do this.
他必须要告诉人们，我们不是这么做的，我的天父不是这么做的。
I don't know how many of you have children.
我不知道你们有多少人有儿女。
I was talking to my translator, and she told me she was just became a grandmother.
That was last year.
Last year?
Last year.
Oh, okay. Last year you became a grandmother. But it's 8 months old, right? Yeah, that's still new. 8 months is still new.
我们在聚会以前，我们在交通，我就跟牧师说，我去年有了一个外孙。
And Christine, you told me you have two children. Yes. I have two daughters and four grandchildren.
我有两个女儿，四个外孙女。
Okay, I'm going to just tell you.Chinese people are very close to our families, very close to our children, very close to our grandchildren.
因为我们中国人呢是非常重视家庭，我们跟我们的子女、跟我们的孙子女都非常的亲近。
I want to tell you, if my daughters or my grandchildren ever did anything to dishonor God or dishonor what it means to be a human being, I would be very upset because that is not how I raised my children.
但是如果有一天我的儿女呢，他做的事情是非常的，不尊重人，不尊重神的话，我会非常的愤怒，因为我不是这样子教育他们的。
Your children can do that.
你的孩子做那样子没关系。
Because I'm not your father.
因为我不是他们的父亲。
But if you are in my family, this is how my family should behave.
但是如果你生长在我的家里，我的家人不是这样子做的。
And this is the temple.The temple of the true God, and Jesus is his son. This is how family operates in the temple of God, and we don't gouge people with 20% interest a day, and we don't gouge people with four times the price of a little bird.
所以耶稣在这里，他要表达说，这个是圣殿，这是代表神的地方，是我神的家里。在这里呢，我们家的人不是每天要取20%的利息，也不是要把卖鸽子卖到四倍的价钱。
Because in the mind and purpose of God, this whole thing for a sacrifice being simply a bird was to allow all people, whether you were wealthy or poor, to come to Christ.
因为神真正的目的呢，要是让甚至于穷人。都可以买一些鸽子来敬拜神，所以每一个人都可以到神的殿里、神的家里。
You don't know how important this is that Jesus had to do this.
所以你知道为什么耶稣必须要做这件事。
We come in and we dress up really nice. I had to get my suit and my wife ironed the suit this morning.
我今天来呢，我必须要穿得很整齐。来之前呢，我太太还帮我烫西装。
I came to a worship service in Santa Clara.
因为我是来到 Santa Clara 来这里敬拜神。
But at the heart of worship is something beyond the clothing and my driving here.
但是真正敬拜的中心呢，却是远远超过我来到 Santa Clara， 而且我穿什么衣服。
It is no matter where we are, no matter where we're from, no matter how much money we have, the purpose of God is that we have all equal access to God because that is what God is all about.
所以神真正的心意呢，是不管我们住在哪里，不管我们从哪里来，不管我们有穿什么衣服，有没有钱，每一个人都可以来到神的面前，这是父神的心意。
When I was growing up in New York City, I lived in Chinatown.
当我在纽约长大的时候，我是住在中国城。
And my parents were relatively poor.
那我的父母呢，其实蛮贫穷的。
He was a waiter.
我的父亲他是在餐厅的一位侍者。
You think of waiters, let's say there's Chinese people who are waiters in the Bay Area, you think, oh, okay, the working class people, not maybe can't afford to live here.
所以当我们想到餐厅的侍者呢，我们就知道他们不是赚很多钱，他们也可能没有办法住在湾区。
My mother, who I just visited last week, for probably 40 years, sold clothing in New York City.
我母亲呢，大概在纽约，她就是做车衣的，做了40年。
And you know what's remarkable? That, you know, in the Bay Area, to say your father is a waiter, it's not impressive. It's not impressive at all.
你知道，很奇妙的是吗？我们都知道，在湾区，如果你说你的父亲在餐馆做一个侍者，可能这不是什么很显赫的事情。
But in the mind of God.Where you are from, and how much money you have, and your family background doesn't make a difference.
但是在父神的心中，你从哪里来，你赚多少钱，你的家庭背景怎么样，一点都不重要。
And when you think it does make a difference,
但是如果我们心里觉得这些事情很重要
，If you think it makes you better, or then Jesus will kick over the tables.
但是如果你觉得这些事可以让你比较更好一点的话，耶稣就会来推倒你的桌子。
Because Jesus in a few days will die on the cross for everybody.
因为再过几天，耶稣就会在十字架上为全人类舍命。
And whether you were rich or you were poor, everyone will have equal access to the mercy and grace of God.
因为不管你有钱还是你贫穷，每一个人都可以直接来支取神的恩典和怜悯。
So he had to make a stop at the temple.
所以他必须在圣殿里停下来。
To show exactly who is accessible to God.
让他们知道到底谁是可以来到神面前的。
But there is a second, and you know, I had an aspect of prayer here, but I'm just going to go on to the second point.
那还有另外一个点。
The second narrative or episode starts in verse 14.
第二个部分呢，就从十四节开始。
And I will read verse 14 and 15, and it goes like this. And the blind and the lame came to him in the temple, and he healed them. But when the chief priests and the scribes saw the wonderful things that he did, and the children crying out in the temple, Hosanna to the Son of David, they were indignant.
十四和十五节。在圣殿里有盲人和瘸子到耶稣跟前，他就医好了他们。祭司长和文士看见耶稣所行的奇事，又见小孩子在圣殿里喊着说：“侯撒那，归于大卫之子”，就很生气。
Now, I hope you see something very interesting.
我希望在这里我们可以看见非常有意思的事。
In the first story, Jesus is upset.
因为在第一段呢，耶稣很愤怒。
In the second story, the chief priests are upset.
因为在第二段的这个故事里面，却是祭司长和文士很愤怒。
Actually, Jesus seems pretty calm here.
但是第二段的时候，耶稣蛮镇静的，蛮安静的。
So what gets these chief priests upset in the temple?
所以到底发生了什么事，让这些祭司长和文士很生气呢？
And it appears that Jesus wants to get them upset.
而且看起来好像耶稣就是要他们生气。
Verse 14, it's very clear because Jesus heals the blind and the lame in the temple.
在十四节我们看得很清楚，耶稣在圣殿里治好了盲人和瘸子。
All throughout the life ministry of Jesus, Jesus was healing people.
在耶稣所有的事工里面，他都不断地在医治病人。
And the people loved him for that.
而且人都很爱耶稣，因为他医治他们。
But before he goes to the cross and before he dies for us and before he is resurrected, he needs to make a stop in the temple and heal one more time.
然而在耶稣上十字架复活升天之前，他必须再在圣殿停一下，再一次的来医治。
Now I have to be correct. There's actually one other time he healed, you know, the ear of the servant, but we're not going to talk about that.
但是我如果我们严格来说呢，这不是耶稣最后一次。他最后一次医治是在哥西马利园，他医治了那个被砍下来的耳朵。
Why does he heal this last time, and why is he doing it in the temple?
那为什么他要在圣殿里医治病人？
Because the temple represents the very place of God. It represents the intent of what worship was in the sight of his Father.
因为圣殿呢代表神的同在，而且它代表神的心意，代表敬拜的地方。
And if the first point in the overturning of the temples is that the house of God is to be accessible to all people,This second one is very, very interesting because it reveals that the house of God was to be a place of true restoration and transformation and even a place of healing, physical and spiritual and emotional.
所以在第一段里面，耶稣推倒了兑换银钱之人的桌子呢，是说在这里呢，圣殿是给所有的人都有一个平等的机会来到神的面前。但是第二个地方呢，第二个故事呢，就表示说，圣殿必须是在这里有恢复的关系，而且呢，在这里他在这里有恢复，甚至有医治。
Now I'm sure that this church has seen its share of God's working in miracles.
我相信在我们中间，我们也看过神所行的神迹。
I'll share you a story.
我要跟你讲一个故事。
My mother.In law, who is I think 83 or 85, is very ill.
我的岳母差不多是83-85岁，她最近非常的体弱，她生病了。
Last year, she suffered four strokes.
光光去年她就有四次的中风。
Strokes come in two types of strokes.
中风呢有两种。
There's the blocking stroke,
有一种呢
where
就是
your vessels get blocked, and then there's the bleeding type.
有两种的中风，一种是脑血栓的中风，就是血管被堵住了；另外一种就是脑溢血的中风，就是血管破裂而溢血。
She had the bleeding type.
那她的是脑溢血的中风，就是脑部内出血。
And each one could have killed her.
那每一次呢，都可能夺去她的生命。
The last one sent her into what we call vegetative state, which means she does not respond.
到最后一次呢，中风之后呢，她等于是进入了一个昏迷，她没有办法她没有办法有反应。
Yeah, she just doesn't respond to anything.
她不对任何事情都没有反应。
And I had a lot of my pastor friends pray for her.
所以呢，我有许多牧师的朋友为我的岳母祷告。
And about 6 weeks ago, I texted my pastor friends a note.
差不多六个礼拜之前，我就送给我的牧师朋友们一个简讯。
And I texted them and said, something incredible has happened. For my mother-in-law.Came out of her vegetative state, and even though she is still needs a lot of help, she is aware.
我跟他们说，有一件神奇的事情发生了，就是我的岳母已经从植物人的这个状态里清醒过来。虽然她还是病得很重，但是她已经很清醒了。
Had one pastor friend said, you know.And this is what he said. He said, "Help, Lord, help me with my unbelief."
那其中有一个牧师呢，他就回我，他说：“主啊，帮助我的不信，帮助我的小信。”
Now I do not know what will happen to my mother-in-law.
我不知道我的岳母将会如何。
But I knew that she and her husband were very devoted believers.
但是我知道我的岳父母呢， 他们是非常敬虔的基督徒。
I don't know whether she will ever get fully well since she is maybe 83 or 85.
因为她已经是83或85岁了，所以我不知道她将来可不可能完全的复原。
But I give praise to God for what He does in the life of believers when we pray to Him.
但是我真的很赞美感谢神，当信主的人向他祷告的时候，神听我们的祷告。
Because if you've ever seen God work, when it appears that nothing else can correct the situation, if you ever see God work, it is a time when you are reminded that God is real and God is alive and God is working in the lives of those who follow Him.
但是如果当我们看见在不可能的情况下神工作的时候，我们就重新的被眺望起来，我们知道我们的神是真实的，他是活着的，而且他与信他的人同在。
10 years ago I was struck with what we call autoimmune disorder. I don't know how you can translate that.
十年前呢，我得了一个那个免疫力的 autoimmune 是免疫力失常的病。
Yeah, the body attacks itself.
就是我自己的免疫力呢跟自己的身体打仗。
I was very ill.
当时我病得很重。
Couldn't move my arms.
我甚至于没有办法动我的手臂，而且我总是非常的疲倦。
So, in about, I was 3 years. I have Kaiser, and I had 3 years of medication.
所以呢，我是在 Kaiser 看病，我差不多吃了三年的药。
And after 3 years, I said I don't want to take any more medication. It's not helping me.
三年之后呢，我说我不要再吃这些药，这些药对我一点帮助都没有。
And the side effects was worse.
而且呢，这些药有很严重的副作用。
So I decided, well, I'll just see if God will allow me to get better.
我就说，我要来看看神是不是会让我复原。
And what was very interesting, it was a long process. It's been probably 9-10 years.
这是一个
I'm fully well.
这是一个很长的过程，差不多到现在也有八九年了。现在我完全的复原了。
If I have pain, it's because of old age.
如果我现在身体还有疼痛的话，是因为我现在老了。
The strangest thing is that if they took a blood test today, I still have the blood disorder.
但是很奇怪的是，如果他们验我的血的话，我现在的血还是不正常。
But I've come to believe something very, very remarkable about God.
但是我相信神做了一件很奇妙的事。
That God is very, very much concerned about me and very, very much caring about me. And I give praise to Him for His ability to sustain me emotionally and physically.
我非常的相信神非常非常的在乎我，他关心我，而且他可以帮助我，他可以帮助我，支持我。
And if you ever see that in your own walk,You will be so uplifted by the presence of God.
如果在我们跟随主的路上，我们也经历这些事的话，我们的灵就会被这样子眺望起来。
You see, Jesus healed the lame and the blind at the temple, and you know what the result was? The chief priests and the scribes were all upset.
所以在圣殿里呢，耶稣把盲人和瘸子医好了。但是祭司长和文士看见了，却非常的生气。
How could people be upset at healing?
为什么有人会因着别人得医治而生气呢？
You know how they could be upset at healing? Because according to the text, it was so magnificent that little kids were giving praise to God.
为什么呢？因为在圣经里告诉我，我们这些神迹奇事时，小孩子们都在圣殿里开始敬拜赞美神。
But we all know worship should be very, very quiet and solemn and peaceful.
但是我们知道，要敬拜神的时候，必须非常的严肃，非常的肃静。
And who wants worship where people actually give praise to what God is doing, and maybe raising their hands, standing up, giving praise and screaming of the goodness of God? Who wants that?
但是谁会想要大家来敬拜神的时候是吵吵闹闹的，举起手来大声的赞美神呢
？I'll tell you, at this service when Will had the prayer and stuff.I loved it. I loved the prayer in this worship service.
你知道今天早上当 当 William 弟兄在带我们敬拜的时候，我非常喜欢他叫我们大家围在一起祷告。
Because sometimes we think that formal worship is all that God wants from us.
因为有的时候我们想说，神要的只是那个很正式的那个敬拜方式。
Sing great songs from the music team. Maybe that's all that God wants.
我们会或许想说，我们跟着敬拜团队唱歌，这可能就是神所要的。
Or to listen to a sermon, that is what God wants.
或是我们来教会，我们来听讲道，这可能就是神所要的。
Or to give offering when the plates go, when that's what God wants.
或许呢，我们就是来奉献，当奉献袋传来的时候，我们就奉献，可能这就是神所要的。
Or even to partake of communion, that is what God wants in worship service.
或许呢，在敬拜的时候，我们来擘饼，这是神所要的。
These are all good things.
这些都是很好的。
But if we only did these things, we would be participating in worship.
但是如果我们只是做这些事的话，我们只是来参与这个敬拜。
In this cleansing of the temple and the healing of the blind and lame, Jesus wants to be participants in worship.
但是在在医治盲人和瘸子的 这些事情上呢，神也是要这些成为敬拜。
We worship God not because God people tell us to worship God.
所以我们敬拜神不是因为别人告诉我们要敬拜神。
We worship God because He has been so good to us, and we see it that we have to give spontaneous praise to the power and goodness of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们敬拜神呢，是因为我们看见神爱我们，他为我们所做的事情多么的奇妙，所以我们就自然而然地发出了对神的敬拜，对神能力的赞美。
Well, that's a whole different type of worship.
这就是完全不一样的敬拜。
Because that's a worship from the heart.
因为那是从心里发出来的敬拜。
That's a worship from experience.
因为这是从经历里而发出来的敬拜。
Because you know that the songs that sings about the greatness of God has revealed itself to be true in your walk with God.
因为我们知道，我们所唱的这些歌词在讲神的伟大的时候，我们跟随耶稣曾经经历过。
And Jesus had to demonstrate this in the temple before he would die on the cross.
所以在耶稣上十字架受死之前，他必须在圣殿里来把这些表达出来。
Sure, there is a temple.
是的，那边有一个圣殿。
Sure, there are officers in the temple, chief priests and scribes.
而且在圣殿里面有祭司长、有文士、有这些服事的人。
There was formality in the temple.
在圣殿里面也有仪式。
But they had missed the entire purpose.Of what it meant to worship the true and the living God.
但是他们完全错过了这个真正敬拜的目的，是来敬拜神。
And once they missed what it really meant to worship the true and living God, Jesus goes crazy, upset.
但是当他们没有真正的在敬拜这个真神的时候，耶稣非常的愤怒。
I think I'm coming to the end of the message.
我想我已经来到信息的结束。
Where are you today?
今天我们的光景如何？
And I'm going to ask a very important question.
这是一个很重要的问题。
Why do you worship here?
你为什么来这里敬拜？
Why did you come here?
你为什么来这里？
I will give you some reasons.
我可能给你一些的理由。
Some come because you have friends here.
有些人来教会里，因为我的朋友在这里。
And I'll tell you, it's very good to have friends at church.
那当然，在教会里面有朋友是很好的事。
Rather have friends than no friends at church.
那比在教会里没有朋友要好得多。
As a matter of fact, if I had no friends in church, I pray I wouldn't go to that church.
如果在教会里都没有朋友的话，我可能不会来这个教会。
Some might come to church because of responsibility.
有些人来教会可能因为他们有责任。
I feel guilty. I need to do something.
我会有罪恶感如果我不来的话。
Or some of you have responsibility in terms of what happens on Sunday morning in terms of music or teaching or children's ministry.
那或许呢，有人来教会呢，因为在这里有服事的需要，有责任，可能在敬拜，可能在教儿童主日学。
That's a good thing.
这也是一个很好的理由。
Because there's so much ministry that needs to be done at a church.
因为在一个教会里面有这么多的事工需要人做。
Some of you come because maybe you were forced to come by your parents.
那有些人来呢，可能是因为你们父母，逼你们来的。
Or your husband or your wife forced you.
或是你的丈夫或是你的妻子强迫你来的。
Well, that might be not good reasons, but it's good because you came to church.
或许这不是一个很好的理由，但是至少你来教会了，那就是好的。
But I will tell you, the only reason that counts, that matters to God.
但是让我告诉你，只有一个理由对神来说他在乎，他重要。
First, do you understand the true grace of God, that He doesn't care about how rich or poor you are, that whoever you are, wherever you came from, the grace of God is found here, and you come to acknowledge that grace.
第一点我们必须知道，不管你是从哪里来，不管你是有钱没有钱，神的恩典都在这里，所以我们来呢是因为神的恩典。
And if you do not understand this grace, I would ask you to understand it and to really understand what Christianity is about.
如果你还不认识这个恩典的话，我希望我鼓励大家能够来认识这个恩典，知道我们信的信仰到底是什么。
The second reason is based upon the second episode.
第二个原因呢，就是在第二个故事里。
That you realize that God, that you realize that Christ, you realize that the Spirit has done great things in your life, and you come because you have to understand that we worship a God.Who is deserving of praise in real time?
我们第二个理由呢，是因为我们要知道父、子、圣灵他们对我们的人生有美好的计划，而且我们必须来到圣殿里面，在不仔细的用真实的态度来敬拜他。
You say, well, Pastor Jeff, how do we get this? We all want to experience God in real time.
但是我们会说，牧师啊，我怎么样可以在即使在任何时候都能够经历神的恩典。
There's a verse I did not talk about in this sermon.
有一节圣经我今天没有讲。
It is found in verse 13.
就是在第十三节。
He said to them, "It is written, 'My house shall be called a house of prayer,' but you have made it a den of robbers."
就是第十三节。耶稣在这里对他们说：“经上记着，我的殿要称为祷告的殿，你们倒使它成为贼窝了。”
There are two things I understand about seeing God work and seeing God vibrant in your life.
那我们必须当我们看见神在我们的生命里面做真实的工作的时候
，First, it takes the presence of Christ because Christ will heal the blind and the lame.
我当神在做奇妙的工作的时候，我们知道。第一个就是耶稣的同在，因为耶稣可以医治盲人和瘸子。
Second is a heart that truly yearns to pray to God.
那第二点呢，就是我们必须要有一个完全向神降服的一个祷告的心。
You know why prayer is so important? Because it reveals my need for God.
你知道为什么祷告这么重要吗？因为祷告显出了我们对神的需要。
Here we live in the Bay Area and we're in Santa Clara. It's probably one of the most successful areas financially, economically in the United States.
如今我们住在 Santa Clara, 这可能是整个美国里面经济最有成果、最成功的地方。
It's so successful, financially successful, that people can't even afford to live here. It's so successful.
因为这个地方是这么的有钱，这么的成功，很多人都没有办法搬进来，没有办法住得起。
With that success comes good things.
那当然，这个成功都会带来许多的好处。
For I always feel it's better to have some money than to have no money.
因为我总是觉得有钱总比没有钱好。
But with that success comes a very dangerous thing.
但是。这个成功的背后却有非常大的危机危险。
And the danger is we have no reliance and no need for God anymore.
这个危机呢，就是我们不再需要神了。
Technology is our God.
科技变成我们的神。
And that cannot be.
它 不能成为我们的神。
Because no matter if you are extremely wealthy or a high-tech guru or very, very poor, we all need God because we all suffer and we all face the problems in life that are common to man.
不管我们今天是很有钱、很高科技，或是我们很贫穷，我们都需要神，因为我们每一个人都面对生命的问题，这个问题是关乎每一位的。
To see God, that He is real.
我们必须要来认识神，他是一位真神。
To see Christ, that the commitments we made to Christ are real, and that we are much more vibrant now than we have ever been.
当我们也要来认识基督，我们就可以得着这个生命，是我们从来没有得着过的。
Because we serve a true and a living God.
因为我们所侍奉的乃是永生的真神。
And we have stories to tell.Of the greatness of God.
而且我们有经历过，我们可以讲很多的故事，这来赞美神。
After his stop at the temple, Jesus will do one more great thing.
在耶稣停在这个圣殿之后呢，他会再做一件伟大的事。
He will spend a little bit more time teaching. He will have the last supper, the last Passover meal.
圣殿结束之后呢，他可能再会讲一点道，而且有最后的晚餐。
But the great thing that he will do is he will march his own life, be betrayed and crucified on the cross for us.
但是最伟大的事就是他把自己的生命交出来，他让人出卖他，然后被钉死在十字架上。
Why does he need to do this?
为什么他需要这么做呢？
And why does he have to stop at the temple before he does this?
那为什么在他上十字架之前，他必须要停留在圣殿里？
Because at the end, the greatness of the temple and the purpose that the grace of the temple and the healing of the temple cannot come without Jesus dying on the cross for us.
因为在圣殿里所彰显的这个神的恩典和神的怜悯是没有办法成就的，如果耶稣不死在十字架上。
Because at the end, none of us are deserving, and none of us can do ever what God would want us to do.
因为我们没有一个人配得，我们没有一个人做得了神要求我们做到的。
So Jesus will die for us.
所以耶稣必须为我们死。
And through that death, forgive us, for he says, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
借着他的死，他可以饶恕我们，就像他说的，父啊，饶恕他们，因为他们所做的，他们不知道。
And with his death, he will begin the unification of the world by bringing all Jews and Gentiles to him.
借着他的死，他可以把世界上的这些信徒都合一，不管是犹太人或是外邦人。
Christianity, which started as a Jewish dominant religion,
当基督教刚开始的时候，大部分的信徒都是犹太人。
We all testify because most of us are Asian here.
当然，我们可以在这里做见证，我们大部分的人都是亚洲人、亚裔人。
You know why we are here?
你知道为什么我们在这里吗？
Because of the grace of God to us.
因为神的恩典。
You have to understand the grace of God.
我们必须要了解神的恩典。
When I was a little kid in Chinatown, why would Christians come and plant a church in Chinatown, New York? The grace of God.
为什么我可以小的时候在纽约的中国城信主呢？因为有人在中国城建立了一个教会，因为神的恩典。
For no one can stop the grace of God.
因为没有一个人可以阻挡神的恩典。
No one can stop the power of God.
因为没有一个人可以阻挡神的能力。
And it is my prayer that you understand this morning in this worship service.
所以我的祷告就是希望今天我们大家都能够明白。
So that when we give praise, it comes from the depths of our heart because we know.
当我们赞美神的时候，我们的赞美和敬拜是从我们的心发出来的，因为我们真实的明白了。
Give me the honor of praying for you.
让我来为大家祷告。
You don't need to translate. Our Heavenly Father, I just give thanks for this time to give this sermon here and to share with my brethren, beneficiaries of the grace of God, beneficiary of the power of God, beneficiaries of the grace of God. as you bless this church and bless the people here and the staff here, Lord. May we always understand what is at the center of worship and at the heart of worship, and that we would not be caught in the formality, but we would always have a vibrant heart, a center that understands your grace and your goodness, and that causes us to give spontaneous praise to you. If there's anyone who is in need here to see the mighty hand of God work in their lives, I pray that we would offer these prayers to you and that we would see you at work wherever, whatever our requests are, that you may lift us, that you may reveal to us that you are alive and vibrant in Santa Clara. May you bless us, O Lord, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for our sins and was resurrected on the third day, and who ascends on high and is at the right hand of the Father, Lord, who has promised to return. You are worthy of worship. For we pray this in the name of Jesus our Lord. Amen. Amen.